Hey everyone, this is DZ Maven here, and it's time for another Gunpla unboxing video. I've decided after some thought that I'll probably start doing a bit more Gunpla unboxing videos of the new kits that I pick up. This here is the Master Grade Gun Tank. I know this isn't a new kit, but it is new to me, and I think it's a more interesting kit. It's a little bit unique because it's not a typical humanoid mobile suit here. This is half mobile suit, half tank, and I've wanted to actually pick one of these up for a long time now, and I had the money, I have some time, decided, you know what, I'm gonna go ahead and pick this up and build it because it looks really interesting. And there's, even though this is a pretty simple looking Master Grade, there's actually quite a lot of gimmicks on here. As you can see right here, I just have it standing up here with the box here, but what I want to show you is some of the stuff that's actually on the box that talks about the gimmicks on this here. There's actually quite a lot going on here, so let's take a look at that first before I actually get this thing open here. Let's start on the side here. It tells you a little bit about some of what's going on with this kit here. There's not a whole lot in the accessories department, but there is a lot of stuff going on inside of it here. And one of the first things you're going to notice here is that the treads can actually separate from the main body and can be adjusted, move around a little bit as if they're actually on arms or legs almost. It's not really a full articulation, but it does give the kit some additional posing options. In addition, there is a lot of these plastic springs throughout the kit here. There's several inside the actual tread suspension of this kit here. And there's also one that is actually inside the cannon here to replicate sort of a springy effect here. As you move on down the side here, there's a little shock absorber. This is some sort of switch to actually raise and lower the treads on the sides of the kit here. In addition, there is sort of a simulated firing, I don't know what you want to call it here, on the little gun barrels on the arms here. You can rotate the piece here and the little gun barrels will kind of move in and out to simulate firing. That's a little neat little gimmick in here to talk a little about the internal waist articulation of the kit here. So there is some waist articulation in it. Even though it looks like it'll be a brick, it does have some articulation to it. Moving on to the other side of the kit, which actually talks about, even shows off a few more gimmicks of this kit. You have the tank treads, which are all individual pieces. I think I recall it's like 86 pieces or something like that. I don't remember the exact number, but that's probably in the manual. I'll get to that in a moment. I do know a common complaint with this kit here is that these treads like to come apart on this thing a lot, but I guess we'll see how that works out here. And as you move on, we do have there's some additional gimmicks here, like a brace for the cannons that comes out of the chest here, opening vents on the torso. And it comes with not one, not two, but four figures of characters from Mobile Suit Gundam. We have Hayato Kobayashi, we have Ryo Jose, we have Bright Noah and Mirai Yashima, which kind of odd that they're included in this kit because they never pilot mobile suits, so I'm not really sure why they're included here, but you have them if you want them. And moving on, there's some additional gimmicks for the gun tank. There's some panels that open up on the main body. And in addition, this is one of the probably more interesting features of this kit. It does come with a LED, and the head, there are areas in the head that light up. There are some eyes on the head that light up. And in addition, there are some light up panels on the cockpit, inside the cockpit here, which is a really unique feature to this kit here. I really can't think of any other Gunpla kit that has light up cockpit in it. So this is a really neat thing here. So I'm kind of looking forward to seeing how well that works out here. In addition, you have your typical opening cockpit and stuff on there. It does come with a 2.0 core fighter that's included with this kit here, the same one from the Gundam 2.0 Master Grade here. So let's get this thing open and see what we got here. All right, so getting the box open here and see what we got here. I have my manual on top already. We can kind of flip through it real quick here. It's going to be mostly the same stuff that we already talked about here. But we got, let's see, on the runners here, hopefully spotlight doesn't block it out too much here. 13 runners here. I don't know how well you can see. I know my spotlight is kind of blinding that out, but if I turn it off, and you can't see anything, so. But anyway, I always post some photos of the manual in my image gallery below, so you can always check it out down there if you want to see more of this in detail down there. But yeah, construction is going to start with the core fighter here, and then move on to the rest of the body. I'm not really going to go through this too much here, because you can see it down below if you want. But part runners here, we got 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, and 11. 11 bags of part runners here. So let me get these open and we'll take a closer look at them. Alright, so before we get to the part runners, there are a couple things here to take a look at here. We do have the sticker decals that come with this kit here. I may or may not use these. I'll decide by the time I actually get the kit completed if I'll use them or not. I know with some of these 1-year war 2.0 kits, I don't like to put the decals on because I think they look better without them, but if I decide to use them, I'll use them. I don't know. A lot of stripe decals. A lot of stripe stickers on here I see here, and those sometimes can be a bit of a pain in the butt here. There are these also additional these little, I don't know what you would call them, like warning stickers. These are supposed to go over the barrels from what I saw on the manual. So I'm not quite sure why you would want to use these, but I guess they're there if you want, or you can use them for something else, I guess. But you got that. And you do have the, there's a sheet of dry transfers for this kit here. It's quite a lot, actually, and several tiny ones here. So this is actually another complaint that I've kind of generally heard about this kit here, is that the dry transfers on this kit are numerous and kind of difficult to apply. So like I said, I may or may not use the markings for this here, but we'll see what happens here as I build it. And probably real quick here, we do have the LED unit that comes with this kit here. It looks like the typical Bandai LED unit that comes with most that you get on most kits. Probably since the time this kit came out here, it takes the two. Let me check again here. Yeah, there it is. That's what I'm looking for. The LED unit takes the LR41 batteries. It takes two of them. So you're going to need that if you want to light it up. Okay, so moving on to first runner here. This is our A plate here. We've got our white. This is sort of a creamy off-white. Same sort of white that was in the Gundam 2.0 Master Grade. A little bit of light gray here and some basic red parts for the kit here. Basically, I have all the parts for the core fighter right here. There is another blue plate we do have that all coming up here. And we do have a section of clear parts, including clear parts for the core fighter and clear parts for the canopy on the top of the gun tank here. So the red is kind of, I don't know how I want to describe it here. It almost looks like the cheap red that Bandai used to use on their older Master Grades, but I know this really isn't that old of a kit. So, but it does look like these parts would be a little on the fragile side, especially these little antenna pieces here. So take care when snipping those out. And B plate, here's the rest of the parts for the core fighter here. This is the blue pieces for the core fighter. This is a different blue from the dark blue on the gun tank. This is a lighter blue that matches the 2.0 core fighter from the Gundam 2.0 kit here. So that's pretty much all this is here. C plate here is a part plate of yellow parts here. Mostly looks like the sort of detail parts here. We had the parts for the opening vents right here. And we do have our figures here. There's six of them. There's two pilot figures that go inside the gun tanks, go inside the gun tank and the core fighter. And we have our four standing figures. They're all molded in yellow, which is, I would have preferred that then I had put these on with the white plastic runner instead of yellow, because yellow is going to be a hard color to paint on top of. Because you want to paint these up properly, you're going to have to primer these in white and probably you have to primer these up in white paint first before we try and paint them here. Otherwise, they're just going to look yellow, which is not the best color for a figurine. Okay, D plate here. This is our runner of dark blue. This is mostly going to be parts for the main body of the gun tank here. We've got these really big parts for the bottom section of the gun tank here. And here's some parts for the upper body right here. There is some nice level of detail on here, considering this is, I mean, it's not a 2.0 kit. I mean, this is the only gun tank master grade there is, but it's made to kind of go along with the 2.0 Gundam. So it has, but it has like a little bit more surface detail than that kit here. So I think it looks pretty nice overall here. And there's a little bit of detail on the inside here on this, these plates here. And E-Runner here, we got two of these here, you know, duplicate runners. These are looks like they're going to be the blue parts that go on the sides of the tank treads mostly here. Again, there's two runners of these. Okay, F plate. We're getting into our first runner of internal frame parts here, and as you can see on here, these are ABS plastic, so they are going to be a little tougher and a little slightly more break resistant than normal polystyrene plastic here. But these are all parts for internal frame. We got parts for the torso, I can see here, probably the sides of the torso here, I think, and some parts for the holding the core fighter in, and more parts for probably just the inside of the torso here. And I think this is the internal waist area that was kind of shown on the side of the box there. And I think these are, they look like kind of like a skirt armor pieces here, but I know there isn't any skirt armor on this kit here, so we'll see what those are for. All right, and G runner, another runner of gray ABS plastic here. We have our sides for the bottom half of the gun tank here. In addition, we have all of these plastic springs and pistons that are going to be all over the sides of the kit here. Now, I do want to make a note, this is ABS plastic here, and if you aren't aware, ABS plastic is a bit more sensitive to paints and enamel thinners, so especially with all these little springs here that have to kind of bend and have some tension on them and everything like that, I would be very, very careful about painting these, because these things probably are meant to bend a little bit here. And what enamel thinner does to ABS plastic, it tends to make it more brittle. So it's more likely to crack and break. So my suggestion is you may not want to paint these at all here if you're trying to paint this kit here. Or if you do paint them, never ever try to put any tension on these things here, because they may just snap on you. So, but I'm not going to be painting this, so I'm not going to be worried about that here. So, but anyway, that's just something I kind of wanted to really point out here about all these little plastic springs here on this thing. Okay, next runner is our H plate here. We have some more internal frame stuff, and this looks like it's mostly going to be stuff for those tank tread areas here. Support frame for the tank tread. There's a lot of detail on this here, which is pretty typical of the Master Grade 2.0 line. There's, I mean, some of the kits are really not heavy on external detail, but they have a lot of internal detail on their parts here. And same is true for the gun tank here. There was a load of internal detail on these side treads here. So if you're going to be painting this and doing detail painting here, there's a lot of stuff to paint in here and just make it look really good. I mean, really really put your detail painting skills to the test here. You do get two of these runners, one for each side of the gun tank. Okay, next runner, we do have a couple more runners of ABS plastic here. These look like some more parts here, and I suspect these are parts for the arms here. We do have the spring here that goes inside the cannon right here. Again, same thing. You may not want to paint this here because you may run the risk of cracking that if you paint that and then try to put any tension on it. So, but again, this looks like it's going to be parts for the arm here. I know this is from the backpack here. These are all the little cannon shells for the main cannon on the gun tank here. This goes on the backpack here. I think this is really cool that they included this detail on the kit here. So you can go ahead and paint all those up in whatever color you want and have a massive magazine of cannon shells on the back of the gun tank here. And again, you do get two of these runners. All right, next runner up is the J runner here. This is not ABS. This is just standard polystyrene. And this looks like it's just going to be parts for the main cannons on the gun tank here. You get both cannons on here. And they're molded in such a way so you don't have to have like halves of cannon barrels glued together and then try to sand off the seams and everything here. They're just molded in straight up in one piece here. So that makes it really, really easy and very convenient for the builder. And next runner here is K-plate here. Again, this is not ABS. This is just standard polystyrene. And this looks like it's going to be some external parts for the arms here. We have our little Bob missile launcher cannon pieces in here. And all of these tank tread wheels are on here too. They are basically in two pieces here, a front external side and an internal side to the tank tread wheels. There's some detail on the inside of these wheels here, so we'll have to probably do some panel lining on the inside of these wheels here to really kind of draw that out. And just a lot of repetitive parts on the side of the tank tread, so this is going to take a while to panel line and detail up here. You do get two of these, so there is double the fun here, as they say. All right, and finally, the last runner here, we have the L plates here, and this is our tank tread pieces here. All individual tank tread links here. You can see there are five on a section here, so 5, 10, 15, 20, double that, 40. Double the runner, you have 80. So we have 80 individual tank tread pieces that come with this kit here. I believe you don't use every single one of them. I think you only use, don't remember the exact number, I think it's only like 36 or something per side here. So there will be a few left over here, but it's probably okay that you have a few extras just in case you lose any. But again, all these things you're gonna have to do panel lining on, so that's gonna be fun. All right, guys, so that's gonna be it for the unboxing of the Mash Grade gun tank here. I'm probably gonna be snapping this up and working on it a bit throughout the week here, so probably will be re a review later in the month sometime. I do want to review the other two of the 1 Year War Trio before I put this review up, so expect those pretty soon in the near future here. So anyway, guys, hope you liked the video. Leave a like, and thanks for watching, and I will see you guys in the next video. Bye bye.